For some reason, there's a commonly held belief that Mother Nature gave humanity all the brains and gave the brawn to the rest of the stuff on this planet. However, it turns out that we might not be as smart as we think we are. If these are anything to go by, it turns out that our fancy high-tech gadgetry was invented by nature way before us. Number 5. To scientists, the Oriental Hornet was a mystery. Unlike other species of wasp and hornet, they're mostly active when the sun is at its hottest, a phenomenon which goes against the popular reasoning that, in order to conserve energy and maintain a healthy body temperature, animals are most energetic when the sun is lowest. It was only through analyzing the biology of the hornet that scientists discovered why. The brown stripes on the hornet are grooves which trap light and refract it into two distinctive beams that then pass through a series of pinhole depressions in the yellow stripes and mix with the naturally occurring pigment xanthopatrin to create electricity. Effectively, the hornet is able to convert solar radiation into electricity, which it then uses for activities, including burrowing. Even better, the hornet uses some of this electricity to operate a complicated system of heat pumps inside its body, which act as a built-in air conditioning unit and enable it to stay out in the sun for longer without overheating. Number 4. As the name suggests, the parasitic wood wasp is a terrifying creature. You see, these guys like to lay their eggs inside wood grubs. However, these grubs are commonly found inside trees, branches, and other wooden things. So, in order to find the grubs, the wasps have developed a variant of ground-penetrating radar. Using their antenna, they tap the bark repeatedly, which sends a pulse into the wood. When the pulse hits something, the signal bounces back and is received by the super-sensitive receivers in the wasp's feet, thus creating a subterranean map of the wood. In fact, this radar is so sensitive that it can pick up the signal of a grub that isn't even moving. Once they've positioned themselves on top of the grub, they then burrow into the wood using their built-in reciprocating drill and impregnate the grub with their larvae, which then proceed to eat the grub from the inside out. Number 3. While taking a routine high-speed photography study of animals' movement at Cambridge University, scientists noticed something strange about the locomotive processes of members of the Isus genus. They appeared to have gears attached to their legs. On closer inspection, it was discovered that this was the case, marking the first known instance of mechanical gears being used by animals. Used to synchronize the movements of the creature's legs, these gears allow the Isus to jump with pinpoint accuracy at the extraordinary speed of 13 kilometers per hour. Although that might not seem like much to us, when you consider that Isus commonly grows to 2.5 millimeters, 0.1 inches, it's a level of acceleration relative to their size that we humans are entirely incapable of. However, there is one downside. These gears are only present in nymph insects, as they are lost during the transformation into an adult. Number 2. In August 1925, a large fire broke out and devastated an oil depository in Coalinga, California. Among the ruins, investigators found hundreds of melanophila beetles, also known as charcoal beetles, a strange fact considering that this species wasn't a resident of the region. Later studies of this phenomenon concluded that the beetles had flocked to the site from the foothills of the Sierra Nevada, over 130 kilometers away, and the site of several large forest fires years earlier. This incident is testament to the amazing infrared sensors that this beetle is naturally blessed with. The shell of the beetle is dotted with hundreds and thousands of tiny water-filled spheres, approximately 0.02 millimeters in diameter. When infrared radiation is present in the air, the water in these spheres expands, and the resulting change in pressure is detected by the beetle, which then moves to reach the fire. But why are they equipped with such technology, you might ask? Simple, because the species lays its larvae in freshly burned trees. Number 1. Flashlight fish are predominantly nocturnal and are only rarely observed by scuba divers during the day. They spend most of the daylight hours hidden in caves or holes in the reef surface, as they feed at night, away from the reef surface, and likely use their light organs to help them locate small, planktonic prey. Like many species that produce light, the flashlight fish has a muscular skin flap that it can manipulate to reveal or hide its light. In this manner, it likely also uses its light to communicate with others of the same species, and to confuse predators. The flashlight fish is likely naturally rare. It is not eaten by people, but is occasionally captured for use in public and private aquaria. As an inhabitant of vulnerable Pacific coral reefs, this species' fate is tied to that of its preferred ecosystem. Destructive fishing, climate change, ocean acidification, pollution, and other problems threaten coral reefs around the world and risk the fishes and invertebrates that rely on them.